thing in your life. So come up to the front. Let's be open and expectant to what he has for us this morning.
So good.
and it is truly amazing. Jesus, we are so thankful for what you did on the cross. God, we come to you this morning with open arms, with open hearts, God. Thank you.
great song. What a great song that is. Christ has risen for us. Right now, and for the next few minutes, we're going to take communion, so I'm going to ask you to take a seat. Now, for communion, anybody can participate who's a believer in Jesus. You don't need to make Liberty Church your home. If you believe that Jesus is your Savior, you're welcome to participate in communion. And if we could have the communion elements passed, that would be awesome. Thank you. I'm going to read a few verses. They're the traditional verses about the Lord's Supper, which you probably have heard dozens of times. But every time that you hear them, think about what it is that Jesus did for us by laying his life down for us so that we may be free, that we may be free of ourselves, of our habits, of our sin, of our hopelessness. Jesus has brought us to a place of hope. He's brought us to a place of peace. He has brought us to a place of purpose. So let's read these verses. This is from 1 Corinthians 11. And on that night the Lord Jesus was betrayed. He took the bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And in the same way, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "The cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." By taking communion, it is our opportunity, one of our opportunities, to proclaim that Jesus Christ has saved us. In this moment, there are some opportunities that we have which are public: baptism, or evangelism, or